right? This is the last question of model paper 2, question number 7, right? Yesterday we have discussed up to the question number 6, end of the question number 6, the about the linear programming. Today also I urge you to refer that video again about that linear programming question. This is again a decision theory question, because decision theory was tested 2 years ago. Thereafter, no question about decision theory. Therefore, there is a possibility to test this decision theory question in this time. From the decision theory, you have two type of question. You can be tested for two type of questions. One is decision tree, to draw the decision tree and identify the possible outcomes and calculate the probabilities. Or other one is the decision rule, maximax, minimax, minimax regret rule. Those things can be tested. Two things, decision tree or decision rule can be tested. Here I have included a decision tree questions, right? Let's see what they requested. Justify the advice of the research firm by drawing clearly labeled here, clearly labeled decision tree, right? Incorporating all the above given information and evaluate with relevant calculations two options of investigating and not investigating, right? Now that company may have two options, investigate or not. Is that clear? However, now you need to evaluate what is the best option, not to investigate or investigate. To evaluate those two options, you need to use decision tree, right? Before moving to this, I will explain what are the theories you have to use in a decision tree when you are drawing a decision tree. Decision tree is a technique of establishing the possible outcomes, different scenarios, right? Generally, decision tree help you to identify one alternative out of many alternatives. Is that clear? Therefore, decision tree definitely started with the decision point. Decision point will be presented as a square, right? You may have two or three alternatives. Say alternative 1, 2, 3. I'm talking about the theory. Then the starting point, it always started with a decision point. As the business, you need to select one out of these three. When you have to select one option out of many options, is point called decision point. Then the outcome of this option may depend on the probabilities, say 20%, 50% and 30%, right? When you have many probabilities of the outcome, the answer here will be the sum of each branch after multiplying by the probability. Is that clear? If you have value here 50, 100 and 300, then 90, 50, 140 plus 10, 150. Answer will be 150. This is not a decision point. Here you will take expected value. Is that clear? You will take expected value. When you have probabilities of the outcome, this point called outcome point. Outcome will be calculated as a probability, expected value. Thereafter, you will select one option out of three. Say here outcome 100, here outcome 200, then you will select 200 as the answer, right? Therefore, a circle used to point out a decision point, sorry, outcome point, and square will use to show a decision point. When you add a decision point, select one decision out of many decisions, but in a probability branches, you have to get the expected value to take the outcome point. Generally, decision tree is started with the decision point. Why we will develop a decision theory tree? to select the option, select an option. Therefore, you have to start with the decision point. Is that clear? Right. Now let's see the question, how we need to develop this labeled decision tree. Let's read the question. Dumax Private Limited operates a standard costing system and prepares variance reports on a monthly basis for management decisions. Company has recorded adverse labor efficiency variance for some months. Though the company has a proper operations in place, it has investigated all these adverse variances in the past. They are practice source. Once they identified the variance, they were investigated it. Based on these reports for the last 36 months, following estimates have been made. Let's see what are the estimates. 80% of variances stem from a random cause and such no corrective action was taken. Right? When the variance arise on random cause, you have not taken, that company had not taken actions. Then 80% of variances due to random cause, then you can say the balance 20% of variance occurred due to non-random cause. Is it clear? The variance occurred due to random cause or non-random cause, right? The percentage of random cause 80%, non-random cause 20%. It would be 20%, right? Corrective action was taken for all variances caused by a non-random occurrence, and such corrective action has eliminated 95% of the variance. Is it clear? If it is a non-random cause, the probability is 20%. You will take corrective action. Clear? Corrective action will eliminate the variance at 95%. They non-eliminate the variance 5%. Got it? The average cost of conducting an investigation was 225,000. If you investigate, your cost is 225,000. An average cost of 800,000 has been incurred by DPL to correct non-random causes. To correct that investigating cost 225,000, corrective actions will take 800,000 cost. If you are going to correct it, you have cost 800,000. Further, it has been observed that correction process has taken a period of time during which some production activities has to be stopped. If you are going to correct your variances, sometimes you need to revamp your production process. You have to revamp your internal controls. When you are going to revamp your controls and processes, you have to cease your production. Is that clear? If you are going to revamp the processes or internal controls, you need to stop, cease your production. Then during that period you cease the production, you have a loss. You are unable to, you won't be able to earn income. Then you have an opportunity cost of making corrective action here. Further, it has been observed that correction process has taken a period of time during which some production activity has to be stopped. These, the present value of the lost contribution due to the production stoppage is estimated to be 200,000 and it is not included in the formally indicated cost of correction, because previous paragraph mentioned the correction cost is 800,000. If you are going to correct it, you have additional cost of 200,000 also at the opportunity cost. Therefore, total cost of correction is 1 million, right? Company suffers losses with a present value of 6 million if variances stem from a non-random cause are not eliminated. if you are not going to eliminate variances occurred due to non-random causes, your cost will be 6 million if you not eliminate it. The probability of eliminate 95%, not eliminate 5%. By analyzing the information, a research firm has advised management to continue investigating all the future variances and take corrective action if the cause is a non-random occurrence. That's the research organization given to you. You are management accountant of the company and management has asked you to develop the decision tree, clearly labeled decision tree, and find out whether they need to investigate or not. Is it clear? Okay. I will give you 5 minutes time to develop the decision tree. From this point, the information are important. Okay. Let's take 5 minutes and try to develop the decision tree. Okay, let's try to develop the decision tree. Now you require to make a decision whether we are going to investigate or not. We are in a decision point. Our decision point is to see whether we will investigate or not. Right? Investigate not investigate. Clear? These are two decisions we have to take. If you are not going to investigate, not going to investigate, no issue. But if you are going to investigate, the variances have two types of variances. The variances may be right random and non-random. Non-random, right? Random and non-random. The corrective action was taken for all variances. Sorry, 80% of variances stem from the random cause, from a random cause, and as such, no corrective action was taken. 80% of variances arise due to random cause. Then 20% of variance will arise due to non-random cause. The 80% of variance stem from a random cause, and as such, no corrective action was taken. We are not going to take any actions for random cause. The corrective action was taken for all variances caused by non-random occurrence, and such corrective action has eliminated 95% of variance. Right? 95% of variances was eliminated, then 5% not eliminated. Is it clear? Let's see the values now. An average cost of 800,000 has been incurred by the company to correct non-random costs. Further, it has been observed that correction process has taken a period of time during which some production activity has to be stopped. The percent value of the lost contribution due to production stoppage is estimated to be 200,000 and is not included in the above 800,000. Therefore, if you are going to eliminate it, your total cost was 1 million. Is that clear? Company suffers losses with a present value of 6 million. If the variance stem from a non-random are not eliminated, the cost will be 6 million. Is that clear? If you not eliminate, your cost will be 6 million. If you eliminate, your cost will be 800,000 plus opportunity cost of 200,000. Is that clear? By analyzing the information, a research firm, in addition to that, there was another cost initially mentioned. The average cost of conducting an investigation was 225,000. Investigating cost 225,000, right? Average cost of conducting an investigation 225,000. Is that clear? Now you need to include the values. Calculate the value from right hand side to left hand side. That's how it should be done. Once you develop the decision tree, calculate the values from end to beginning. That's how study pack also explained. Right? Now incorporate the values. Right, now this is the outcome point. You need to take the expected value, 95% of this and 5% of this. 95% of the eliminate and non-eliminate, non-random, non-eliminate, right? What is the value here? $950,000 plus $300,000, 1,250,000, 1,250,000, clear? Then here 20% only to taken to there, how much? 250,000 plus 225,000, because these are expenses, right? 475,000 is the total cost, right? Now, how we are going to take the decision? That is the question. How we are going to take the decision? Now, if you correct it, you have a 475,000 cost. Then how you say, okay, do investigate or not to investigate? How we will take the decision? Let's take the question again. Right, Suraj. Right. Dumax Private Limited operates a standard costing system and prepares variance report on a monthly basis for management decisions. DPL has recorded adverse labor efficiency variances for some months. Though the company has a proper operations in place, it has investigated all the adverse variances in the past. Based on this report, for all the 36 month following estimates have been made. 80% of variances stem from a random cause, and as such, no corrective action was taken. For random causes, no corrective actions taken. Clear? Then 80% is due to the random cause, then balance 20% would be non-random cause. Corrective action was taken for all variances caused by non-random occurrences, and such corrective action has eliminated 95% of variances. Right? Now compare the sentences given in the question with your answer. Right? Corrective action was taken for all variances caused by non-random occurrence, and such corrective action has eliminated 95% of variances. Then 5% of variance not eliminate arise due to non-random causes. Clear? The average cost of conducting an investigation was 255,000, the average cost of conducting an investigation. That is the, if you started a research, sorry, investigation activity, you have a cost of 225,000. An average cost of 800,000 has been incurred by DPL to correct non-random causes. Further, it has been observed that correction process has taken place of time during which some production activity has to be stopped. The present value of lost contribution due to production stoppage is estimated to be 200,000. Therefore, corrective action will take 800,000. Opportunity cost you have 200,000. Therefore, for corrective you have 1,000,000 cost. And it not included in the formally indicated cost of correction. DPL suffers losses with a present value of 6 million if the variance stemmed from a random cause are not eliminated. Sorry, non-random cause are not eliminated. If you are not going to eliminate your errors, clear, you have 6 million loss. But not eliminate variances stemmed from a non-random cause. Clear? That is not about the random cause, right? Now, if you investigate, your total cost will be 475,000. Is that clear? If you not eliminate, what happens? You need a value here to compare and select. Is that clear? You need a value here and compare and select. Now listen what happened in this branch. Suraj, is that clear? Right. Investigate random or non-random cause. You will correct only non-random causes. Eliminate, not eliminate, that's clear. Not investigate means you are not going to do anything, but you have the variance, agreed. You have the variance due to random and non-random. Is that clear? You have the variance due to random or non-random. Random will be 80%, non-random will be 20%. Therefore, you have outcome point here, right? Even you not investigate, you have the variance due to random or non-random. Is that clear? Right. Random you are not going to correct, non-random are you going to correct or not? That's the question. You will correct if you investigate, otherwise you are not going to correct it. You correct here because you investigated and correct. Without investigating, you are not going to correct. If you not correct the non-random cases, you have 6 million loss. Got it? You cannot take here, eliminate and non-eliminate. Why? Not investigate means not eliminate. Is that clear? Therefore, if you not eliminate, you have 6 million loss due to non-random causes. Therefore, here you have a loss of 6 million, here nothing. Is that clear? Therefore, you have here $1.2 million. Am I correct? Now here cost will be $1.2 million. Now what do you recommend them to do? Investigate and correct random variances since it's take the lowest cost. Is it clear? 475,000 lowest cost. Clear? Because if you investigate, you will select non-random and correct, eliminate or not. But if you not investigate, you keep silent. But there is the variance. Variance occurred due to random or non-random. If you keep silent, non-random will create a loss of 6 million. Is that clear? Not investigate means no correction action, you will be silent. But you have the non-random variance and loss of, if you not correct it, you have 6 million loss. Therefore, write down the answer. It can be recommended to investigate the variances and correct non-random variances. It can be recommended to investigate variances and take corrective actions for non-random variances. Is that clear? Since it goes given the lowest cost. Okay. Right. Let's take the second question. Is sensitivity analysis calculate the minimum probability? Calculate, you have to be careful in this question, right? Calculate minimum probability of random occurrences for the variances. Now take your decision tree you drawn and highlighted what they are talk about. Calculate the probability, you need to calculate the probability of what? Random occurrences. Now see the decision tree you drawn. The probability of random occurrences means you have two branches taken for non-random occurrences. Investigate non-random occurrences 80%, not investigate non-random occurrences 80%. Is that clear? You have to calculate that probability under which circumstance for the variance in order for you to advise management not to investigate further variance. Is that clear? Right. Let's see here. Calculate the probability of random occurrences. This is the probability they are talking about. Am I correct? This is the probability they are talking about. Calculate the probability of random variances to say not to investigate. To say not to investigate, at least these both two costs need to be equal. Then you will say, even though investigate or not say. Say not to, now you will tell investigate why this is lower. If this value reached 1.2 million, you will say, don't investigate. Is that clear? Therefore, to say not to investigate, this 475,000 shall equal 1.2 million. These two need to be equal to say not to investigate. Right? To say not to investigate, if this stood at 80%, this is better. Is that clear? If this is change, this will change. Clear? Because this is 1 minus 100 minus 80%. That's how you have taken 20%. This 20% was taken 100% minus 20%. 80%. If you reduce this, this will increase. If this will increase, value will increase. And when you reducing, this will increasing and this will increasing and finally this will increase. When it's reach this value, you can say don't investigate. Clear? Right. Therefore, for this side, we have to rewrite the formula. How you have taken 475,000? You have taken 225,000 fixed value plus this fixed value plus this value. Is that clear? How you have, now you need to say this total need to be equal to 1.2 million. Now you need to find out what would be the probability. Say it is X. If it is X, this will be what is? 1 minus X. Got it? No issue here because no value here. Then definitely this value is there because this is not to talk about that random non-random. 1.25 million into 1 minus X. Is that clear? Plus this, should be equal to this to not to say investigate. Is that clear? How you have calculated this? 1.25 million into 1 minus x, then you have this answer. Is that clear? Plus this is 475,000. If this is 80%, if this is 80% as in the original question, this side will be 475,000 and it will be the worth option. Now we need to say not to investigate. Say not to investigate, that cost should be equal to the other option. Clear? Now you can easily find out what is the value of x. Is that clear? Okay, tell me the value of x. $225,000 plus $125,000 minus $125,000 x equal $1.2 million. $225,000 plus $125,000 minus $125,000 x equal $1.2 million. $350,000 minus $125,000 x equal $1.2 million. Right? -$1.2 million. X equal 850,000. Clear? X equal 850,000 divided by minus 125,000. X equal minus 6.8. If nondendrum variable becomes 6.8, is that clear? Other one become 93.2, is that clear? Right, because here we have used it as a minus, then to take this 1 minus 6.8, then other part is 93.2. If random variable becomes 6.8, right? 6.8 means, sorry, there was a mistake. Let's see what was happened. These figures are correct, right? In which line we have the mistake? Is that correct? Yeah, Uda? This line? What was the issue? 125,000. Oh, sorry. 1.25 million. Wow, wow. I did a mistake here. I lost 1 0. Got it? Yeah. I lost 1 0 here and 1 0 here. Then this will be 1.25 million plus 225,000. Then 1.45, is that clear? 1.45 million. 1.45 million. Correct? 1.45 million minus 1.25 million x equal 1.2 million. Then x equal 1.25 million x equal 1.2 million minus 1.45 million. Right? Correct. Is that 1.45? All right. 4.75. Here 1.475. Then x equal minus 2.75. 2.75 divide by 1.25. Correct. Then how? Then you can eliminate that minus sign. What is the percentage? 22%. If this is become 22%, this will be 78%. If random variable probability, variation probability become 22%, it is worth not to investigate. Is that clear? This call, what this call? Sensitivity analysis. You will take the existing situation and we are focusing to change one variable on the formula and see what is the condition we want. We wanted to change random variable probability, therefore we have taken it as x. Is that clear? Then other rate will be 1 minus x. Then not to say investigate, the cost of not to investigate and investigate need to be equal. Therefore we have used this formula to do that. Is that clear? Therefore, if non-random variation probability reduced from 80% to 22%, better not to investigate. Is that clear? Right. This type of that, this is generally decision 3. This is the further analysis of decision 3. That's the point. Okay. Oh, you may have another question like this. Here you know you have 800,000. Clear? 800,000 corrective action cost. Clear? Then examiner will ask, write down. I will give you a question, additional question. Calculate the cost of the corrective actions, direct cost of the corrective action, because you have indirect cost that's called opportunity cost, right? Direct cost of the corrective action to say investigation is not worth. Now, current situation, what was the current situation? This is an additional question, right? Not in the paper. This is the present situation. AT% and 20%. Is that clear? Now this is profitable. To say not to investigate, both costs need to be. You want to say not to investigate. Not to investigate cost is 1.2. Therefore, other side cost must equal to that 1.2. Currently, it is 4.75. Other side 1.2. 2 million. To say not to investigate, this should be equal to this. What they are asking? What is the cost of, direct cost of investigating? Eliminating. Direct cost of eliminating means, this is cost of eliminating. That is 800,000 plus 200,000. They are asking, by how much this should be increased? What would be this cost to say not to investigate? Is that clear? Now we need to calculate it. We need to take it as what? Now tell me. This will take as X. And finally, both costs need to be equal. Right? Okay. Therefore, rewrite the formula for this side. Now you cannot take this value. Is that clear? This value and this value was taken. If I take the existing values, assuming that 800,000 they are, right? Here 225,000 plus 250,000. How we have taken 250,000? This into 20%, right? 20% this. How you have taken this? 95% of this and 5% of this. Therefore, 95% of X plus 200,000. Plus 5% of 6 million. Clear? Would equal to 1.2 million. Is that clear? Now find out X. Is that clear? This is cost of eliminate 95%, cost of non-eliminate 5%, then non-random occurrence 20% plus initial cost of investigate should be equal to 1.2 million, then you can say not to investigate. Is that clear? Let's solve within the bracket first. Keep in the original bracket as it is. Here you can take 300,000, this side. Here you can take 95 into X, 0.95X, correct? 0.95X plus 95% of 200,000 means 190,000. Am I correct? Right. Further, up to some extent I have eliminated the brackets. Then let's take this 20% as 0.2. Now let's try to remove this bracket again. Oh, simply 1.2 million. Here 20% on that means 0.19x plus 38,000 We have to remove this bracket first, because 20% of all sum of both, exactly. Here, keep 0.2, keep 225,000. Now let's try to solve this bracket. 0.95x plus 19,000. 190,000 plus 300,000. Now correct, right? Then you need to multiply it by the 20%. 225,000 plus, you need to multiply everything by 20%. 0.19x plus 190,000 into 20%, 38,000 plus here 60,000 equal 1.2 million, correct? Then we can remove this bracket, 225,000 plus 0.19x plus 38,000 plus 60,000 equal 1.2 million. Here 98,000 and 225,000, how much? Complete values, these and these, the sum. Sorry, 323,000 plus 0.19x equal 1.2 million, right? Therefore, we can rewrite 0.19x equal 1.2 million minus 323,000, right? Then you can say x equal, divide this by 0.19. How much the value of x? 4 million. I can't hear you. Loud to say? 4 million, okay, 4, then next number? 306, 650,000, 15, 000, 780, 789, right. If this 800,000 increased to 4.6 million, better not to investigate. Is that clear? Is currently 800,000. If it is multiplied by 5 times or 6 times, 4.6 million means nearly 5.5 times. Is that clear? Better not to investigate. For any variable, this question can be asked. What is the question here? Develop the original program and remove in the bracket and solve in, that is mathematics, not BMA. Is that clear? I think you got the idea how to make the sensitivity analysis. Is that clear? Let's move to the question again. State 3 causes of variances that would require an investigation to be carried out. What are the causes to be investigated of labor? When labor demotivated, right? Demotivation of employees will increase the idle time. Is that clear? You need to investigate and take action. Because in original science management theory also mentioned, people will have two factors to motivate. Hygiene factor, motivation factors and hygiene factors. Sometimes people will motivate up to some extent. Thereafter, you have to think more factors. Therefore, you have to investigate and correct it. The motivation issues. Is that clear? Or sometimes you may have unattainable standards. That's why you may have variance. Unattainable standards need to be investigated and correct. Right? The errors occurred when setting standards. Employee demotivations, clear? Idle time, The idle time arises not only due to demotivation, right? Due to other matters, right? Sometimes purposely people not work, right? Union actions may reduce the time. Clear? Therefore, you have to think and write down those matters. Now, for example, power cut is not a non-random. Clear? It's a random thing because we can't do anything. That's about issue about the electricity board, right? But employee issues, you have to investigate and take corrective action. Otherwise, it will continue. The demotivated employee need to be motivated through motivation factors or hygiene factors. Otherwise, it will continue. Is that clear? Right. That is end of. Oh, we have another part. Right. Right. The second next part of the question. BDU company is a manufacturer of baby equipment and is planning to launch a revolutionary new style of sporty pushchair. The company has commissioned market research to establish possible demand for pushchair, and following information has been obtained. If the price is set at 425, demand is expected to 1000. If the price is 500, demand will be 730 units. If the price is 600, the demand will be 420 units. Variable costs are estimated at either 170, 210 and 260. You have three prices and three demand levels. Got it? And three variable cost. Is that clear? A decision need to be made on what price to charge. Prepare a table showing expected contribution for each of the 9 possible outcomes. Prepare a table, right, showing the expected contribution for each of the 9 possible outcomes. Got it? Now, you have three prices, three variable cost and three demand levels. Easily we can develop this on a decision tree like this, right? I will just explain the decision tree, then you can easily understand how you have to develop the table, right? Okay, let's see like this. You have three demand levels, 1000 units, 730 units, 420 units. Clear? Don't take this, not the answer. I'm explaining, right? Under this option, you have a single price, 425, 425, 425. Under 730, you have three prices, sorry, same price, 730, price will be 500. You will wonder why I am taking same price as three, because you have three variable cost, then you have three contributions. Even though price level is same, you have three variable cost. Is that clear? Then you have three contributions. Is that clear? Now, when the quantity 420, price will be 600. Now, same price, but your variable cost has three variable cost. variable cost may be 170, 210 and 260. 170, 210 and 260. 170, 210 and 260. 170, 10 and 260. Now you know you have possible contributions. Is that clear? Tell me what are the contributions? 5, 5, 2. Here 5, 1, 2. Here 5, 6, 1. Is that clear? In this case, 0, 3, 3, 0, 9, 2, 0, 4, 2. 170, 0, 3, 4, 0, 9, 3, here 0, 4, 3. This need to be developed in your mind, right? Now see what are the possible 9 outcomes. We have possible 9 outcomes. Clear? Quantity 1,730, 420. Is that clear? Three quantities you have. Under each quantity you have three total contributions. Here you have the single contribution. Now how we rename these boxes? By the price or by the contribution? Now you need to show this. Now you can see here easily you have 9 outcomes, right? Possible 9 outcomes, right? How you are going to put in them into a table? What are the two axes you can show on the table? Variable cost and price, quantity, variable cost and quantity. 1,730, 420. Variable cost 170 or 210 or 260. See, if quantity 1,000, variable cost 170, your contribution will be 255. Therefore, your total contribution will be 255,000. Is that clear? Ready? Because 1,000 units at 425, agreed. 730 units at 500, 420 units at 600, clear? Now contribution will be 425 minus 170 into 1000, is that 255,000? Is that 255,000? Right, now tell me the figures. When it's come to here, 420 minus 210 into 1000, 215,000. 425 minus 260 into 1000 units, 165,000. Clear? Then here, 500 minus 170 into 730 units, how much? Sorry? 400? 40,900. Here? 700. Here? 200. Right? Here? 400 units into 430 contribution. Price minus variable? 80. 600. Then? $800. Right. Now, what is the question there is? Prepare a table showing expected contribution for each of the 9 possible outcomes, is the answer. Each of the 9 possible outcomes. Is that clear? Right. Second question. Explain what is meant by maximax, maximin and minimax regret decision rule using the information of the scenario to illustrate the explanation. I think you can cover up the entire topic, decision 3. This is about decision rule. Previous question about decision theory. So, this is decision rule, previous that decision 3. Right? What is maximax? Explain. Write down what is maximax. The maximum result out of the maximum results. When you have many options, each option you will select maximum results. Out of the maximum results, the maximum one is the maximax method. Is that clear? Write down. Select maximum contribution out of maximum contributions given maximax rule. Now our decisions to be made on what price to be charged. What is the decision you need to take? What price to be charged? You have 3 options. If you charge 425 price, right, your maximum contribution will be 255,000. Agreed? If you charge 500 price, maximum 240,000. Clear? If you charge 600, maximum 180,000. 600. Got it? Under these 3 price options, clear? These are the maximum results. Got it? Write down. Two columns. Price. First column price, other column maximum contribution. Price 425, maximum contribution 255,000. Price 500, maximum contribution 240,900. Price 600, maximum contribution 180,600. You have selected maximum prices, maximum out of maximum. Therefore, your answer will be price 425 at a variable cost of 170. Is that clear? Maximax, maximum out of maximum. Is that clear? Maximum out of maximum, that is maximax. Select maximum of each option, then select the maximum of maximum, maximax, maximum of maximum. Is that clear? Therefore, write down the answer. Price would be 425 at a variable cost of 170 per unit. Price would be 425 at a variable cost of 170,000 under maximax decision rule. Right. Second theory, maximin. Write down maximin. Maximum of minimum. Got it? Current one, maxi, max. Maximum of maximum. Maximums, then maximum one select out of maximum. Here, maximum select out of minimum. Write down. Select the maximum contribution out of minimum contributions under each price. Maximum contribution out of minimum contributions. Is that clear? Right. Write down the price, write down the minimum contribution, two columns. Price and minimum contribution. $425, lowest contribution 165,000. Is that clear? 500 price 175,200. 600 price 142,800. Right. You have taken lowest contributions. Got it? You have taken lowest contribution. Maximum out of lowest. What is? 175,200, circle it. Price is 500. Is that clear? Therefore, write down, price would be 500 at a variable cost of 260 under maximin decision rule. Is that clear? Maximum out of minimum options. Got it? Maximum out of minimum options. Maximum out of minimum options. This is the answer, right? Price 500 at a 260 variable cost per unit. Third point, that is a very important point. See, minimax regret decision. Minimax regret. What is regret? Opportunity cost. Suffer. Suffer means regret, opportunity cost. You have to select max regret, maximum opportunity cost. Then you will select mini out of maximum opportunity cost. Is that clear? Right. How we calculate opportunity cost? You have to make another table here. Look here. Suraj, can I say this? Right. I have to use same table again. Look here. Regret table. Right. I will use another table. Regret table. Same information. Price 25. 500, 600, variable cost 170, 210, 260.
Look here what I am going to do. Regret, opportunity cost. If I select price 425, is that clear? If I select this, I will not select these two. Agreed? If I select this, I will not select these two. Got it? We need to select the price. If I select this, this is the maximum contribution I have. Therefore, other two foregone options, no opportunity cost, because this is the highest. Therefore, opportunity cost is zero. Is that clear? If I select this option, I would have to select this, but I have selected this. Because I would have select the highest option, but I have selected this, then the difference is my regret. Is that clear? How much the difference? 114,100 is the regret. Clear? If I select this, what is my regret? I would have to select the highest option, not this. I would have to select highest option. I have not selected this, I have selected this. Therefore, my regret is the difference between the highest and my selected point. Clear? How much? 74,400. Is that clear? Here, if I select this price, 425, highest is this, no regret. If I select this, 3,300 is the regret. If I select this, I will lose the highest option. Got it? What is the regret? 51,200. Here, if I select this, definitely I have a regret here, because this is the highest option. See, here this is, here this is, here this is. Always reduce highest from highest, therefore, here zero. No regret. Here zero. Because this is the highest. If I select this, what is the difference? 9,800. If I select this, what is the difference? 32,001. Now select maximum regret. Clear? And here, what is the maximum regret? Here? 74,400. Here? 51,200. Here, 32,400. Got it? Maximum regret circle. Out of maximum regrets, you must select what? See here. Mini max regret. Out of maximum regrets, you have to select minimum regret. Minimum regret is 32,400. Right? Write down. Out of maximum regrets, the minimum regret will be 32,400. Therefore, entity shall select price 600 at 260 variable cost. Now actually this is the basic two areas covered in the chapter 16. Chapter 16 is decision theory, right, in your syllabus. Now what you need to do, this is the end of the paper number 2, right? Your study text, chapter 16. This is chapter 16, right? This is chapter 16, which can answer it mean decision making. Decision theory consists of 5 topics: risk and uncertainty, allowing for uncertainty, expected value, decision trees, and decision rules. Right? Expected value table, decision trees, and decision rule. We have discussed these two. Right? Now, what you need to do? You have free time tonight. Try to read that chapter today itself, because this explain with examples. If I take that topic. Decision rule, because decision 3 is easier. If I take decision rules, here, right? Maximin decision rule suggests that decision maker should select alternative that offer the least attractive worst outcome. This would mean choosing the alternatives that maximizes the minimum profit. I will take this example. Suppose we have 3 projects D, E, and F under 3 economic scenario 1, 2, and 3. The best economic scenario, moderate economic scenario, and say worst economic scenario. You have 3 projects. These are the NPV you can generate. Right? The maximin decision rule suggests that he or she should select the smallest worst result that could happen. The smallest result, this is decision criterion that managers should play safe and either minimize their losses or cost, or else go for the decision which gives the higher minimum profit. If he or she select project D, their minimum profit will be -20. If they select project E, got it? Their minimum will be 10. Got it? If they select project F, their minimum will be 60. Is that clear? 60, 10, and 20 for the 3 projects. Project D lowest NPV, project E lowest NPV, and project F lowest NPV. Out of the lowest NPV is maximin, therefore maximum is 60. Therefore, entity shall select project F under the number 1 economic scenario. Is that clear? If you use maximax, first you have to select highest. Here highest 100, then 120, then 85. Out of maximums, this is the maximum value. According to maximax theory, they should select project E under the economic scenario 2. Is that clear? If you are going to the regret,
then you need to calculate the regret first. Is that clear?
If you select project D, you won't be able to select project E and F, but no regret because this is the highest. Is that clear? But if you select this, you have a regret of 20. If you select this, you have a regret of 40. Can you see that?
I'm not going to read about the other two. Is that clear?
I have explained only this line. Now, the minimum regret is here, maximum regret is here,
because we will select maximum regrets.
Here maximum regret 105, selected 105. Here maximum regret 75, selected 75. Here maximum regret is 40, therefore selected 40.
Minimax regret, minimax regret, maximum regrets, but out of that you will select the lowest.
Therefore, lowest will be 40. That is project F under scenario 1. Project F.
Is that clear? Now, I think you read part of the study text. Now, what you have to do? Read the study text completely for chapter 16. Then you will be able to learn. Now, decision rule is okay, I think. Decision rule. Now, you need to read the decision 3. You have examples and answers. Try to read it, try to understand that. Then no need to read this again before the exam. Is that clear? Okay, let's stop the class now. Then tomorrow we can start the model paper 3.